So there's some interesting news today regarding Tommy Robinson from the UK. As you know, Tommy Robinson is a journalist who was recently sent to prison for 13 months because he was live streaming from outside a child grooming gang court case. And now it seems to be he's in prison now, and his family, his wife and children, were going to visit him today in prison to check on him because, as you know, his safety. He has been in prison before, and other times he has been attacked. He had his nose broken in an attack previously, in a previous prison sentence. So his family is going to check on him to see if he was okay and safe and everything. The prison authorities, he is at Hull Prison now, and the prison authorities refused to let his family check on him. They had a meeting set up and everything, but they denied them to come and see Tommy, which is a very strange thing. How is that supposed to happen in a first world country? Because that's a human right. You know, you're. Even if you are a prisoner, you have a human right to be allowed to get visitors. And even in extreme cases, even horrible criminals, you are allowed to get visitors. But this guy who was live streaming from a court case apparently not allowed to get visitors for some strange reason. So I would say this is a really shocking thing. This is pure Stasi methods. You know, I mean, this reminds so much of what they did in behind the Iron Curtain, you know, with Stalin. Let me just summarize what happened with Tommy. He was live streaming from a court grooming gang court case. No one from the mainstream media was there. He was there, the only guy. The police come and swiftly arrest him, and he is then arrested, charged, and sentenced within only just 5 hours. Let that sink in for a minute. 5 hours. From arrest to sentence. I mean, that's kangaroo court to start with. On top of that, the court bans the media from reporting on the story, and no one is allowed to talk about it. Luckily, though, well, thankfully, that ban has now been lifted because of the huge public outcry. But at first, the media was completely banned from reporting on Tommy Robinson being sent to prison. Now Tommy Robinson is in prison, and his family wants to go visit him. What happens? No, they're not allowed to visit him. I mean, Stalin would be proud. You know that. You know, in Soviet, people who were dissidents, they would just all of a sudden disappear at night and be sentenced super quick in a kangaroo court, and then no one would ever hear from them or see them again. And this reminds so much of what is happening in this case now. Let me just say this, you don't have to agree with Tommy to think that this is outrageous. I don't agree with everything Tommy Robinson says. In fact, I disagree with him on a lot of things. But I 100% support his right to free speech, and most important, and even more importantly, I 100% support that everyone should be equal under the law, and that the rule of law should be applied equally to everyone, which very much does not seem to be the case here. It's very clear that this man, Tom Robinson, is a political prisoner, and the British state is treating him very, very unfairly, and not as all as he should be treated in a real rule of under rule of law. You know, so that's what really worries me. It seems like Britain is really turning into a police state with. You know, they're taking it straight up to the Stasi handbook or the Gestapo handbook. You know, Hitler, Stalin, you know, they were pretty similar in how they operated. Imagine thinking that you would be in 2018 and seeing Britain turn into a, well, the police using fascist or communist methods. It really boggles the mind. So, yeah, just thought I wanted to do a quick update on this. Please make sure to retweet and share. And thank you for watching, guys. And I'll see you next time.